Well, guys, it's Thursday, 17th July, and I've been back from Rainbow on my first trip about 3 weeks. I had 2 weeks back in June on the island with Arjun the first week and Jacob the second week. And at the moment, as I film this, I haven't been able to upload those videos simply because Vimeo have now blocked copyrighted music, which is a real pain. And as probably most of you can gather, I do like the soundtrack that generally goes with my holiday, which I play in the car down there on the way back. But I'll leave you to sort of hopefully see that video in due course. Maybe I can upload it while I'm away. I'm leaving that to Cindy, my colleague, and yeah, you'll see there what we got up to. And yeah, it was fun and frustrating, and but yeah, we'll save that for another time and probably allude to it whilst I'm away at Rainbow this coming week. So anyway, just finished packing, and tomorrow morning I set out as usual on my own via the tunnel down to Rainbow, fishing with Kev the Lead and his bunch of mates, and I'm back in 19 with Jim Lightfoot. I fished 19 back in October with Jan. I fished with Jim this time last year in 21. So really looking forward to catching up with Jim. There just for a week, and then the second week, because it was a 2 week trip, I couldn't do 2 weeks. My mate Paul Meatham is taking over where I leave off. So as I say, I'm just going to finish off a little bit of packing, and before I set off in the morning, probably later on this evening, I'll quickly show you guys, for those that are interested, and some of you have asked me, the camera equipment that I've used, and you know, something I'm hoping to use on this coming trip. Right, for those of you that are interested, I'll take you briefly through the camera equipment I use. For those that aren't interested, I'll suggest you skip forward a few minutes. In summary, I'm obviously filming with the camera I normally take. This is an old HD camcorder, but this is the style of camcorder I use. I'm actually using a Panasonic now, but I use an HD camera with memory stick. You know, you can buy them now from 200 to 500 quid. I tend to buy the more expensive one, thinking I'll use all the features, and I never do. So, you know, really and truly, you know, you can get a more budget-oriented camera, Panasonic or Sony. As I say, I've been happy with both, but do get one that you can fit a polarizing lens to, circular polarizing, because it cuts out the glare and can become coming very useful. You've seen these before. These are my glasses. I took the lenses out on my trip last month. Look a right knob, but anyway, yeah, these are recording glasses. They record in 720p, so they're not exactly high definition, but they're accurate. I've had a go at the GoPro this last trip. GoPro's a pain, and I'll come on to that in a moment. I'm using that for something else. So I reverted back to these on my last trip. Simply press this button to start, press it to stop, as easy as that. But most importantly, they're accurate. So that lens in the middle, you know, where you're looking, where you're playing the fish, you know, it's wide enough angle to be, you know, really useful. Haven't got to worry about pressing a button, checking it's in the right place, all this nonsense, which I had to do with the GoPro. So yeah, I've gone back to using these, and yeah, you get these for like 80 to 150 quid. This I've had from a koi hobby. This is an underwater camera from Kodak, about 100 quid's worth. This is brilliant. I don't think they make them anymore, but if you can track these down or something similar, again, I'm going to use this for underwater footage, simply because, again, I'll come onto the GoPro, which again is designed for underwater footage and everything else. I'm using that for something else. This is simple to use, got a big screen so that you can see underwater what you're filming. And I've not used it before for fishing, but as I say, it's been extremely useful for my koi hobby. And, you know, as I say, track these down, very cost effective, brilliant bit of kit. Again, working on an SD card. Lastly, take a look at this bloody thing, right? I'm going to have to go back a bit. There's my GoPro, right? Got a protective lens on it. But this is a Phantom DJI quadcopter. And Lockie's Dave put me onto this, and this is just brilliant. And the idea of this, with a remote control, a bit like you use on a bait boat type remote control, is you fly this, you control the camera from the handset, and my idea is to get aerial footage at rainbow of the lake and send it out to Jim or whoever's got a fish on and video them from the air. If you do a YouTube search, there's some amazing footage people are getting with this, and I've spent the last couple of months trying to get used to it. I had it for last month's trip. I wasn't confident enough using it. I didn't want to ditch this in the water. You know, there's probably $2,500 worth here, all up with the other bits and bobs. But anyway, that I'm hoping to use, subject of course to Pascal's permission. So I'll go and see Pascal Friday night, make sure he's happy with it, and if he is, and you know, the boys are happy me using it that are adjacent to me, then yeah, that's my plan to use this GoPro and quadcopter setup. And as I say, I lay in bed, you know, I get home from a business trip, I've been away for a few days. Most people are thinking about their wives when they get in bed with their Victoria's Secret gear on. Not me. I lay in bed thinking, what footage can I get with that? Honestly, it's sad. But anyway, subject, as I say, to Pascal's permission, that's what I'll be using. And then lastly, really, an iPhone. I get some great photos on this, and video footage even, if I get stuck. So between those items, seems as though it's a lot of kit. There's chargers, there's other lenses, there's all manner of things. But that, in summary, is what I'll be using in the coming week at Rainbow, and hopefully getting some great footage, provided we catch some fish between us. Call me a creature of habit. I'm at my picnic spot just south of Le Mans, 2:30 Friday afternoon. Couple of cups of tea, chill out, no rush to get down there. And well, I come through a real heavy storm when I got up this morning, and the sun come out and it's been baking hot all the way down. So yeah, superb. So yeah, a couple of cups of tea and then I'll be heading on my way. Well, here's my usual start of the holiday synopsis, and if I'm looking tired, it's because I am. I've met the boys in Hostens. We've had a pizza Friday night, so I've drove all day. Is what it is, journey never gets shorter, but the excitement builds as you get nearer. Caught up with the lads. The anglers have been pulled off the lake tonight because we're expecting a really heavy storm. You can feel it in the air. It's not here yet, but and it might be what the lake needs, because it's been fairly slow in a lot of the swims this week. So yeah, fingers crossed. But anyway, going to shoot back now, plot up somewhere out of the wet, and yeah, if this storm comes, yeah, it's meant to be a real heavy one. But yeah, as usual, full of anticipation, and let's see what the week holds. It's Saturday morning now, about 10 o'clock, and the storm come, but it weren't a, you know, really bad storm. So yeah, just grouping now, get round to the swim, set up. It's a lovely morning. There'd have been bites last night, that's for sure, especially with the weather that they've had all week, really hot. But I'll catch up with a couple of the boys here, and then yeah, get round to the swim and yeah, get them out. Again, my typical view from the picnic spot Saturday morning at Rainbow. And there's some lads that are just about to go home, and then a lot turning up. I'll just see, look, see how he disappears. As soon as the camera comes out, he's off, isn't he? Yeah. So you boys are off home now?
We are. All done.
So what's your synopsis of the week then?
It's been hard work.
Yeah?
Very hard. Been very poor for the last couple of weeks. But we all had a few fish, so it was better than none.
And what swims was you in between you?
One and two, second week, five.
Yeah. Difficult. And would you say it's the weather then, generally? It's been so hot.
Yeah, it's been lethal.
Yeah. So I was just saying on camera, shame you had to pack up last night, because, you know, last night would have been a good night to be fishing, wouldn't it?
Yeah. We released a bit of tension in the air, I think. That's just one of those.
Yeah, it's rainbow, isn't it? Take the rough with the smooth,
Definitely.
And what bait was you on then, in rigs? Because wherever you were, come on, I'll edit it out. Yeah.
That's
yeah.
hard, you
do, so, yeah. yeah. Well, it's 9:30 Saturday morning. And, come round. Just waiting for Jim to come round. And here we are back in 19. Jim and I were in 21 this time last year. I was in here with Jan back in October. And this is the scene. The excitement and anticipation builds. Yeah, so right now I'm going to get the house up because it looks like it's going to rain, and you know what, the lake needs some rain. It's been a red hot apparently all week, and you know what, it does help if you get the right conditions, and you know, the water's warm, you know, the fish are probably lethargic. That storm last night weren't a major storm by any means, but you know, hopefully it's kick-started them. And you know, all us anglers, we're all talking up there, we're all instilling confidence into ourselves. You know, don't give me negative vibes, to coin a phrase from a 70s film. So yeah, full of positivity, and right now I'm gonna skirt about and get sorted. So sort of lunchtime for Saturday. Very easy to set up in 19 with your car right down by the swim compared with the island. Anyway, ain't taking long to plot up, and this is the scene. It's getting warm, that's for sure. There's the ever faithful off. It's nice to have the canopy out for a bit of shade. Got enough scope here to be able to do that. So yeah, all very comfortable. Got a couple of more mod cons since my last trip, and this is the scene. Yeah, so we're going to have a light lunch, go up and have a shower and stuff. I mean, in fact, we'll probably go out in the boat before that, because Pascal's cleaning the showers. Go out in the boat with Jim, have a little mosey round, go and have a shower, come back, get the rods out. Well, about 7 o'clock Saturday, Jim's only been out there a few hours, got a bite.
I think it's a bream, Kev.
Bream?
Yeah.
There we go, our first meal. Saturday night, Jim. They're out. We're feeling confident, aren't we?
Yeah, feeling really confident, Kev.
Yeah.
Lake's been fishing slow, past about 4 weeks, but
we're going to turn it around.
We're going to turn it around, mate.
Yeah. And we're at that stage now where it's been a busy day, and they're out, and we're about to eat and have a cup of tea, and now we're in the zone. And that's the scene. It's Thursday, Saturday evening. That sounds lovely, Jim.
Yeah, tastes lovely.
Well, you can safely say Pascal's 24 hours late, because this is unbelievable now. This has just come, and this is a serious storm. We're battening down the hatches. Look at it. And I'll tell you what, the lake's going to fish its head off. I know it. It really has come with a vengeance. I don't know if you can see behind me, but this has really, really come hard. I'll try and capture it. It's bloody unbelievable. Watching this might think I'm a wuss. I've come in the car because that tree is over my bivvy. I'll look at it in the morning, and that's too precarious to be in that bivvy with that tree and this wind. And in fact, I'm going to reverse the car a bit because the tree's a bit too close to my car and all. It's serious out here. I'll try and get it. Yeah, it's really, yeah, that's the heaviest storm I've fished in since Salagoo 1989, I think. Yeah. 7 o'clock Sunday morning, Jim's rebaiting, having been wiped out last night, them two rods from that storm. Do you know what I was going to say? Part way through that storm, well, this is fun. It weren't fun, that was a proper storm. A couple of the lads got wiped out in 21, possibly around the other parts of the lake. Yeah, it was that intense. Not as long as the one I had with Jim in July last year, but the intensity of it, as I say, not since Salagu 89. Our boys, if you're watching this, have we had a storm like that? But anyway, yeah, might as well check all the rods after a cup of tea and some breakfast, because yeah, I would imagine some leads have been moved and so forth, and yeah, get them back out there. Well, it's 2:30, Sunday afternoon. Jim lost one about an hour ago up the back. And we were just saying, it's mad for a bite. I think there's been a couple of other bites around the lake. And you wouldn't think it's 2:30. I'm in the bivvy, it's dark, it's overcast. But be careful what you wish for. We wished for this and it's come. Perfect conditions. And anyone who's been fishing Rainbow the last few weeks will know this lake's needed some wind and rain on it, and that's exactly what we've had since last night. So yeah, conditions are great, and yeah, let's hope we can capitalise on it, that's for sure. Darren's into one there, mid-afternoon Sunday. I think it's snagged. It's one disaster after another. This ain't the Jim I fished with last year. He's now stuck in his bivvy.
Hey!
You're an amateur. Hey, look at the state of you. Can't you get out?
Mate, it's stuck, look at that.
Yeah.
What about a fast run?
Yeah, best place for you. Yeah. Yeah, you Northerners are used to being in prison, aren't you?
You've done this deliberately. Sabotage.
Jim's had his second bite today on the same rod. He's getting it back. Good angling. It's no longer a camping video.
They were angry with the man.
44. Yeah, superb, Jim. Well done, buddy.
Cheers, Kev.
Yeah. Lovely.
Hopefully first of many fires, Kev.
Would be nice.
Alright, let's put it back.
Well, I've just been up for the quickest shower I've ever had. Tea time, Sunday. Jim put that fish back half hour ago. And yeah, really, these conditions are unbelievable. The water will have cooled down with all the rain, wind and stuff we've had. These are carp anglers' conditions. So yeah, got to capitalise because it could get hot and flat calm in the next few days. While it's like this, yeah, these fish are having it. And I wouldn't mind betting there's a few fish being caught around the lake right now. So up past seven, Sunday evening. You've had a fish, Jim. We're off the mark. It's no longer a camping video.
No, it's after days. Okay.
And we got a fry up. We've got our day all mixed up. We'd normally have that for breakfast, but we had curry, didn't we, last night? And not curry again tonight. Mm. So we'll have curry tomorrow night. Yeah?
Yeah.
Happy days. Lovely. It was about half seven Monday morning, quiet night. Or Jim had one in the night, 30 pounder, and he's just had a bite again.
It feels like it's, I don't know. Damn, I need to get on the boat.
Go on, buddy, tell me if you want me to do anything, yeah?
What's wrong with me? I'm going to be close to you. There's eyes here, I think.
Just keep your head down, that's it, you're alright. So Jim's got it fairway back to the bank. He might be snagged there now. Watch your lines, Jim, and yours.
Yeah,
need to go under them. Yeah, nice one, Jim. Nicely done, Jim. That's a serious fish. Well done, buddy.
Cheers, Kev. Thank you, mate.
52.10,
I think.
Yeah.
52.10.
Yeah, well done, buddy.
Beautiful.
Yeah,
cheers,
nice
Kev.
One.
Thank you very
yeah,
much.
Yeah, superb.
Lovely.
It's a mirror, Monday morning, 52.10, superb.
Yeah, it's only sharp, but it's really wide.
Yeah. Lovely, Jim. Yes.
Thanks, Kev.
Well done.
Beautiful fish.
Come round to help Darren Edgehill, fishing swim 18.
Well, you ain't helping, are you?
No. I'm filming though, Daz. He's had a great night, 250s last night, 40 pounder this morning, and now this bit of a lump.
Actually, we should fly it.
Oh, well, yeah, it's
a 50, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a, looking like a big 50, I think, as well, Daz. I'll put the camera down for 2 minutes and give Daz a lift. Yeah, I just weighed it. It's just over 60 pounds. It weighed 66 pounds on the scales, just deducted the weight of the sling. Quite a nice looking mirror. In fact, it's beautiful, really. Typical of a rainbow fish. It's very, quite a short fish, but broad across its shoulders. Well done, Dazza. Well done, mate.
Cheers, mate. Cheers, Jimbo. I'm going to put her back. Is that okay?
Beautiful, mate. Yeah.
Good.
Cheers. There she goes.
Look at that. Colossus. Oh, that's a nice shot, that. Clear water. Imagine seeing, if you saw that. There looks a big fish there today.
It's a big fish.
Well, you know. Yeah.
So there's young Ben, fishing with his dad in 17. Caught a few then?
Yep.
So what are you at? Tell the camera quickly.
69, 44, 50, 50 something,
and 37. Yeah, well done, superb. And now I've come round to Darren, who's in 18, and his second big one today.
Well, I'll be buggered.
52 pound. Yeah, nice one. Well done, Del. Yeah, superb. Yeah, nice long shape, nice fish.
Because it was really long, it's not that wide, is it?
Yeah,
it's
well done. I've not fished here. And where are you? How are you fishing this, Del?
Just how they all do, really, mate. I've got one on the Golden Bush. Which is, I don't know why they call it the Golden Bush.
Because it's not golden?
No, it's a cut of twigs, mate. Right. So if you see the lovely green bush,
yeah.
And you've got a dead tree next to that,
yeah.
It looks like a little gap, and then some sort of stick sticking out,
yeah.
And that's the Golden Bush.
Right, yeah.
A dead tree there, to the right of the little lovely green bush.
Yeah.
One there, don't know what they call that. And then probably 15 yards from that, mate, to the right, there's one they call the stump. And if you go out there, you can see a tree, which has been sawn off, which is straight in front of that tree, really.
Right, yeah, very nice.
14 foot deep. That's it, mate. And now once it's around the corner.
Yeah, good. It's been a productive swim, this.
I think it always
has,
mate.
As your swim as well. Yeah, good angling. Right, boys, I'd better get back because I might get a bream, Ben. You never know. Yeah, well done.
Well, I just went round to Darren to video that fish for him, take some photographs. Yeah, cracking fish. And, between him... 17 Jim, the island, I think they've been the hot swims, the last few weeks. What I need to do now is I'm in a hot swim, I need to catch one. And I always say it, pressure's on. I could really, really do with one. Anyway, yeah, let's get back there and have a cup of tea. And I'm going to position one of the rods. And yeah, here's what it is.
Well, guys, slightly unusual end to a video. It's Saturday, 26th July, and the last footage was whilst I was at Rainbow, which was on the Monday, which was a couple of days into my week, and I had a family bereavement on the Monday morning. So I came home on the Tuesday, drove home all day Tuesday. Had our mum's funeral yesterday. It's now Saturday, so I'm gonna keep this footage. Not least of all, there's some good footage on it, but also in a perverse way, a sort of a slight memory of my mum. And I know she never watched my videos. But she knows how much I enjoyed making them and how much I enjoyed fishing. So, I need to keep this footage. Anyway, on a brighter note, that memory out of the way for a moment, I'm going to keep this footage until my trip, which will be my second trip, with my good buddy Eric in October. I think as I speak now, it's the back end of October. Liaising with Eric right now. So what I'll do is I'll bolt this footage, which I think is about 20 minutes long, I think, on the front of that, and edit it accordingly. And I think I'm confusing myself right now. But anyway, that's what I'm going to do. So this is going to conclude the trip, which, thanks to Kev the Lead and, you know, the great opportunity of fishing with Jim again, didn't quite work out. But sometimes that's life. Well, guys, it's Friday, 3rd October, and tomorrow I'm off to Etang 5, which is just north of Paris, a 100-acre lake. I'll come on to that in a moment, but to rewind slightly, I just uploaded my Castle Lake trip, which we booked with Angling Adventures. That was early September. And that was a fantastic week. More a camping holiday for me, but that's fishing at times. But yeah, wonderful venue. And got back from there about 3 weeks ago, I think it was. To rewind before that, I did that trip, some of you might know, Rainbow in July with Jim Lightfoot, which I had to cut short due to personal circumstances. So that footage, the couple of days that I was there, will be on my Rainbow start of my Rainbow trip, which is the end of October, when I spend a week with Eric in Swim 11. So anyway, that's the rewind bit. As for now, as I say, I'm off to Etang 5 in the morning. It's only like 2.5 hours from Calais, so as I say, north of Paris. And I'm on there really thanks to Mark Westenberg, aka the Yeti, who I saw at the Zwolle show in Holland back in, I think it was February, beginning of March. And in actual fact, for guys watching this, that Zwolle show is fantastic. Real proper carp boys weekend. Flew out there on the Friday afternoon from Stansted, 45 minutes in the air, and then from there take the train from Schiphol, which is Amsterdam, to Zwolle, which was about an hour and a quarter on the train. And you know, for those interested, even taking your other halves, because you know, Amsterdam's got a lot of good sightseeing, museums and libraries and old buildings and things. So you know, your other half can go and do them, or if you don't take your other half, you can go to Amsterdam, I don't know, look at tulips, all the things that carp anglers would do in Amsterdam really, and maybe spend a night there and then travel to Zwolle for the show. So let's look it up, boys, because it's a cracking weekend, and yeah, it's really good fun. So as I say, back to Etang 5. I'm getting ready now, cooking up some bait, hemp and tigers. I popped in on the lake on our way down to Castle, which I caught briefly on that Castle video. So I've got a measure of it, and you know what happens, you come back. You go and see a lake for the first time. It was flat calm, high pressures, 150 swans on it. But you come back and you start sort of strategizing. And that's what I've been doing since coming back, thinking in your head, your tactics and everything else. So we'll talk about that more shortly. In the meantime, cooking up some bait and skirting around, ready to set out tomorrow morning. So a bucket of tigers, big bucket of hemp, and taking a load of hemp and tigers with me. And I've got my barbecue, cooking some. My little gas barbecue there. That little barbecue, because my Arga oven's no good for trying to cook all this lot. And that bucket by in the next hour or so will be full of hemp. Just took delivery of this boat again that the boys had at Castle. A couple of them. And yeah, ordered one up. And yeah, look forward to using this. And yeah, named it after me mum. Yeah, just to talk a little bit more about Etang 5, as I say, Mark Westenberg, he mentioned it to me when we was at the Zwolle show, that he had a lake that he was going to be an agent for, and it hadn't been fished for a few years. So I was scheduled to go back in April, thanks to Mark, but I couldn't make it last minute. So this week, I've not fished it before, as I say. I'm going to have a week on my own, really, and I want a week on my own because I've got some family letters and things that I want to read, and all. I don't know quite how to put it without sounding all soppy, but I just want a week where I can go and chill and, yeah, read and look at lots of things in my own time. So that's what I'll be doing next week, as well as fishing hard. As I say, it's an 100-acre lake. There's been some serious fish out of there since it reopened back in April. And, you know, those guys who are on the grapevine will know it looks to be a serious venue. So
rather than try and give some facts and figures now, I'd rather get there. Mark's popping in on Sunday so we can have a beer and have a chat and get the facts about the lake, as Mark knows them, you know, as well as anyone. But as I say, some serious fishing. So I've got it in my head, me approach, tied up some rigs, I've prepared some bait, all them things. Some of that could well go out the window when I get there because it's a very, very weedy water. Probably the weediest water I will have, well, by far the weediest water I will have fished in France. So that will have its challenges, not least of all potentially, which I've seen before, when a big wind catches up, it catches your line, moves your lead, all them sort of things. And that's what we want when I'm there. There's been a lot of high pressure this last couple of months. I think the weather's scheduled to break this weekend, so it would be nice to have some wind and rain. With that will bring some challenges, I'm sure, with that weed, particularly this time of year as it starts to, you know, release and move about. But we'll cross that bridge when we come to it, and we'll talk more about the lake, the bait and the rigs once I'm there. Right now, there's no point in being an armchair angler. Got to go out there, bite it on the arse. And as I often say, the difference between going to a zoo and looking at animals behind bars or going on safari and shooting the things, two very different things. And that's the approach I take to my fishing. I don't know if that sounds right. Anyway, let's get on with some packing. Well, it's just gone 7 o'clock and I'm just queuing now to get on the 720 Euro tunnel. Having had some breakfast, sun's coming up, and with the prospect of low pressure coming into France and the UK, come to that, for the first time in weeks and weeks, I'm hoping it switches the fish on. We'll see. Well, 20 past 11 and I'm at Pont-Saint-Maixence, and there's the River Loise, so we're a couple of minutes from the lake. Well, it's midday, got here half an hour ago, but was waiting for the bailiff to make sure we could go on. And identical conditions to 4 weeks ago when we popped in. Roll on the low pressure. So this is our first look at Etang 5, midday Saturday. Arj, just been speaking with your fellow countrymen, telling him I've taught you everything you know, but one thing you taught me, be calm. So that's what I'm going to try and be this week, calm. So I'm not going to charge about, rush around, see if I can take a leaf out of your book, or at least try. Yeah, that's Julian the bailiff. He's just going, just spent 10 minutes speaking with him. Turn it around to me. Yeah, he's basically saying that the crayfish have become a problem since the summer. So that has a bearing on how you prepare your hook baits, maybe mesh them or, you know, use nuts, whatever, tigers. I've seen two fish move to the left in the bay. I heard them and seen the sort of after splash. He was saying that this weed, which I'll look at shortly, in fact you can see it behind me with all them swans, is moving, so any sort of wind will move it and take you out. And because the lake is fairly quiet this week, let's get it in focus, and because the lake's fairly quiet in the week, he said I could maybe go over the point, which is to my left, which probably gives you a bit more scope in terms of avoiding the weed if it starts to move about. So I might just do the night here, maybe a couple of nights, see what happens, and that point gives you a lot of scope. And it might just be I venture over there, not least of all fish are used to probably having lines from this swim, so going over to that swim, you know, it's probably a new angle on the whole thing. But anyway, let me get plotted up, and yeah, we'll see what happens. But yeah, encouraging that I've seen two fish move to my left. Well, it's 3:30 Saturday afternoon and I'm just about to put the first rod out, which is my left hand rod, in the bay. Before I do that, I'm going to launch me boat in honour of me mum, who only ever really drank strong tea, so couldn't think of a more appropriate drink to toast it with than a strong cup of tea. So mum, thinking of you. And there's a boat named after my dear mum. Yeah, so as I was saying, a bit of a breeze getting up now, but this rod, where I saw the fish move in line with more or less that tree there, is where I'm going to drop the marker, just beyond those swans, probably near that fast swan, just past it. Bait wise, as I mentioned briefly yesterday, I've got some almonds, tigers, hemp, sweet corn, boilies. So, you know, we all know you just got to be on the fish, and the fish are in amongst the weed, there's no doubt about that. You know, based on any lake I've fished, especially Harrow in the weedy days, you needed to have weed in a swim, you know, to stand the best chance of catching fish. Bit like barbel fishing, no point in fishing a river in summer that's got weed in a swim that's devoid of weed. Fish don't have it, so unless it's, you know, well into dark. So anyway, gonna get the rod out now. Breeze is getting up, the low pressure's due in, I think, overnight. So yeah, excitement's beginning, and yeah, I'm really pleased to be here. Well, it's about 6 o'clock Saturday, got two rods out. First rod got caught up with some nylon, buggered the engine, all wrapped around it, familiar territory, but it weren't my fault this time. That's my right hand rod out there about 80 yards straight in front of me on the edge of a weed bed. Left hand rod's in the left hand bay. And no sooner than I got the second rod out, it started to piss down just as forecast. It's looking good. Seen three fish moving the bay to my left. Well, it's 7 o'clock, just about to have a bite to eat. And yeah, conditions are superb, they really are. The wind's variable. 1 minute it's going from my left to right, and now it's coming towards me. Not a big wind, but you know, all the confidence you need. So overcast, looking good, got just two rods out. Not sure what this weed's going to do on the wind. It looks like it can move, it's floating, massive beds of it. We'll capture it better when the sun's up and I'm out in the boat with the camera. But so yeah, confidence is high. Tell you what, can't believe this weather has just come in. Look at it, mad for it. I'm in the prime spot. Half past seven Saturday. Swans have moved out. Look at that. Looks superb. Well, just as I thought, my left-hand rod's been wiped out. That wind has just pushed the weed completely across the line. And yeah, and I think my right-hand rod, which is the second rod, I've only got two rods out, I think that one's about to be wiped out as well. So yeah, this could be a pretty daunting place with weather like this. Perfect carp weather, no doubt. But that weed, massive, huge beds of it, is now just drifting around, painful. Setting the scene, 8 o'clock Sunday morning, and this lake is going to be a challenge. I'll tell you what, I've got to say, as an angler, it's quite nice to be having me hat on and me woolly, because it's quite chilly, but you know what, the conditions are spot on. And given the high pressure that's been in France, and as we were saying earlier, you know, and England come to that for so long, it's nice to have wind, overcast and perfect carp conditions. Problem you got this lake? One thing, this Canadian pondweed. I think it's Canadian pondweed, never up on me weeds. But fact of the matter is, it's moving. So it's wiped out both rods overnight. And the weed's probably stayed where it's been for a good while now, because there's been no wind. Now it's moving about, just wipes you out, don't matter what lead you got on the end there. So that's going to be the challenge. Other than that, it's a normal lake, fish it, 100 acres, not massive in the scheme of things, but that weed. So yeah, I think I've got one or two tricks up my sleeve, but they're probably only tricks that, well, we'll see. you know what, just as you're thinking, what do I do next, and you're not too sure, best thing to do, put a kettle on. For speed, I had this soup last night. Don't recommend it. Yeah, repeats on you every 10 minutes, all night. Crap. Thought I said I wasn't going to be negative. Anyway, going to regroup now, get the camera out as I rebait, and need the sun up really to see the challenge of the weed and what's going on out there, but ain't going to hang about now, and get all rods out and do some proper angling, that's for sure. And that's what this lake needs at this time of year. No good for you Kent boys, that's for sure. Yeah, you need to stick to Wolverhampstow. Yeah, you can see there's some meshed bait, crayfish problem here, and just a bit of yellow rig foam. Looks crude, but rigs don't always look like they do in the books when they're in the water, that's for sure. Yeah, a couple of nice Dutch lads, there's four of them here, opposite me, and I think in eight, and to my right in two. They've not got a bait out yet. So a brief look at the gear. Guys, there's braid, a 34 pound braid. On this rod I've got a 30 pound nylon leader, and then through to, that's a 5 ounce lead, the clip lightly put on, towel rubber, that's a link, quick release link, sea fishing one that's strong, not a carp fishing one. Lock is unleaded, and there's the meshed up hook bait with some yellow foam, and that's a really hard bait, a lot of egg albumen in it from Mark at Alchemy Baits. Well, it's about 10 o'clock now, Sunday, and I'm fishing properly now. Got my fishing head on, all positive, so I've got one rod out in the bay that got wiped out yesterday, put that back out. This rod out in front about 90 yards, just beyond that swan, just on the edge of the weed bed. This rod I'm about to put out quite close in the middle of that weed. So basically, subject to what's on the fish finder in that neck of the woods, probably 40-50 yards out, and then I'm going to keep an eye on that area, the middle area, which is where the fourth rod's going to go, probably 200 yards out, well certainly 150 yards out. Well, it's lunchtime Sunday, and I was expecting Mark at Carping Adventures to pop in, which he's done. So just had a cup of tea with Mark, and I thought we'd catch up with him and see what he's up to with these venues that he's got. He's got some cracking venues here in France now. So we'll have a chat with him and see what it's all about. Yeah, I just said to Mark, I had to reset the tripod. I forgot he's 2 foot taller than me. Mark, I'm here 24 hours. Thanks for sorting this out. I was hoping to come here April. Didn't quite work out for one reason or another. So, yeah, good to be here now. I've known of you donkey's years. Saw you at the Zwolle show. You mentioned this lake. What else you got in your portfolio? And, you know, tell us a bit about Carping Adventures.
At the moment, I've got about 21 destinations spread out all over France. A lot in central France. Comfortable drive, 4 to 5 hours from the ports. In Calais. My main objective with Carping Adventures is to actually bring lakes to my clients which I would like to fish myself. I don't like very small lakes which are overcrowded. Everybody needs a bit of space to do their angling, and I got a certain level in my destinations. Good quality fishing, nice sized lakes, the owners I work with have to be good. In other words, they have to be anglers themselves, so they can inform my clients what they have to do if they're not catching. And apart from that, yeah, no salmon fish. And that's one of the most important things. We're here at Etang 5. A lot of rumors going around about the lake. Fish have been stolen, fish have been nicked. Everybody said the big girl was gone. Well, it's been out last week at a massive 86 pounds. I will be back in December myself to catch it, I hope. But yeah, I just want to make sure that people have a good time on the lake. I'm not one of them paper boys who sit behind the desk and you do a reservation, you get an invoice, you pay, and that's it. That doesn't work for me. I always ask the guys, just give me a call if you want to know anything. There's more than just paying and getting a piece of paper. And I think that is the difference between me, myself and the other companies.
Yeah, no, it's fair call. Booking with you and the advice you gave me, and as you've done others, I know from others that have booked with you, yeah, it's all been very straightforward. For us English guys, and I guess the Dutch, anyone now, there's a massive choice of waters now to be fishing.
Yes, when I started up with Carping Adventures, I think I visited about 40 different venues. And some of them were just a blatant hole in the ground filled with water. And, well, with all due respect, but you guys pay a lot of money to go fishing for a week. And I'm not going to put people in a shithole. It's very simple. I have quality lakes, quality venues. I want to keep them that way. So, yes, the rules are strict, but I think that's normal. And when you book with me, you're booking an experience. And that's something else than other companies do.
So, and again, in your portfolio of waters, then, you've got a mixture there in terms of small waters, big waters, harder ones, easier ones.
Yeah.
So your website's giving some insight as to, you know,
yes,
what the
yeah.
lakes are about.
Yeah.
And then anyone who wants to make a more informed decision can give you a ring.
Yeah,
and
just send me an email.
Yeah.
That's what I'm there for. I got lakes from 3 hectares, so around 10 acres, to a massive 180 acres. I can cater for lake exclusive. I can cater for people who want a harder lake like Etang 5 is. But I do also have the runners waters, which appeal to other clients. Everybody has their own demand or wish what they want to do for. When people ring me and ask me, Mark, do you have a lake where we can fish? Yes, mate, I've got 21 destinations. But what do you expect from your trip to France? Which is your one trip a year, because you got a wife, you got two kids, and that's all you can do. So my task is to give you, as a client, as an angler, the best possible lake and the best possible information, so that your holiday is top notch. The only thing I can't guarantee is getting a bite.
Yeah, well, it would be useful right now, Mark. I'm putting you under pressure.
I'm gonna rub your rod.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure I understand that, if that translates. Anyway. Cool. All right, well, thank you. And, you know, I'll overlay your website details and contact details on the video. That website link you sent me, the PDF, which I think is going live next week,
yes.
is your Dutch website. And then the English one, when does that go live?
That goes live by the end of October.
Right,
so
cool.
That will be in time.
Not sure if you can see, but there's some fizzing going on. Centre of the viewfinder. That's about 60 yards. So I'm going to cast there. Mid-afternoon now, Sunday. Mark's just gone. Nice to catch up with him. Certainly got some lovely waters to be looking at, that's for sure. And more importantly, the guy opposite me, the Dutch, they've just landed a fish out in open water, so that's encouraging.
Well, it's tea time Sunday, and you know what, I don't want to sound like I keep complaining, but there are some challenges on this lake. That said, the guy opposite, he's had one, which is great. I don't know how big it was, but he was out in the boat and it was great to see. Encouraging. But you know what now? The swans have gone from my left over to the far bank. Great. They're now moving back. You just hope they don't move back too close to the bank. and take out your floating braid, which is over weed anyway, because there's about 80 swans. So if it's not one thing, it's another.
So it was on the far bank. They're there now. They're slowly making their way over here. And I'm just hoping they keep that distance.
Well, this is what I made at home. We're about to have this with rice. Tea time Sunday.
Mm. 8:30 Monday morning. The swans wiped out my two left rods. Bloody crazy. Simply because your line's running across the weed. We've got a plan. First thing I need is a cup of tea. This is the scene, Monday morning. With what looks like a southwesterly blowing over to peg 4. So I have a plan.
Right, I'm going to phone Julian, the bailiff, and see if I can move, to peg 4. Wind's blowing over that way, it's in the corner. Looks ideal. It's one of the hot pegs apparently, 4 and 5. But yeah, this is crazy, not least of all the wind's coming out of it. So let's phone Julian. Let's see how this goes. Nothing like a bit of reality. See what happens. He's good as gold. Bailiff's really, you know, good lad on here. And I think the swim's free all week, so it might just work out. They need to do something. Hello, Julien? Julien is Kevin from peg 1, Etang. Yeah, hello. Julien, is it possible I move to peg 4? Yes, peg 4. Ah, yes, yes, please, yes, merci. Thank you very much. Yes, yes, okay. I see you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Happy days. Happy days. All turned around. Right, now, in summary, right, I can move over to peg 4. So I ain't even gone round there. I didn't want to wind the rods in and go round. I may as well just get round now. Wind's going over there. Fed up with this swim. You know what? In truth, people would be watching this. What are you? Man or mouse? That's a mouse. I'll tell you what. Let's get over there. Skirt about. Well, half hour after my conversation with Julian, I'm taking my first lot of gear around in the car to peg 4. Go back, get the other lot of gear, and then take me boat over. Just got to check with the lads they're okay, me coming across their swim in peg 5, Jason and James. But yeah, don't take me long to move, thanks to that Oz tent, and I'm excited now. Needed a move. So yeah, let's get on with it. Out of the car. Can't see the boys. This is peg 4. This is more like it. It's obviously the peg there. Wind's coming in. It was set to go southwesterly. Looks mad for it. Well guys, 1 hour ago I was making that call to Julien. I'm in peg 5. Tent set up, most of the gear here. Just going to go back now, get the remainder of the gear, walk back, take the boat. I'm fishing over there, that was peg 1, and bring the boat straight over, thanks to Jason and James's permission. I'm just going to come to the middle of the lake and straight towards them. So you can see, it looks really good. These are the conditions we've been waiting for. On me, behind the wind. Confidence sky high now, guys. You know, every angler watching this can relate to
you know, struggling, have a move. It's like you've rejuvenated yourself, and you can probably tell in my voice, hour and a half ago I was a bit down and out, truth be known, having been wiped out in the night and stuff. Now, you know what, it's like walking into a nightclub with Lockie and me pulling a bird instead of him, or Blakey, or Mark, or Andy, any of them. Always went home on my own.
There's all the gears here, leaving the car, walking round now back to the peg, picking up the boat and bringing it in. Must be a mile round there, must feels like it, but don't want to labour it. That is one hell of a cut, nearly took me toe off. And I've got to walk all the way round now. How hard is that? Yeah, us Essex boys. Yeah, I don't want to labour it, you Kent guys. Anyway, yeah, it's looking bloody good. I'm proper excited, so let's not hang around. It's about 9:45 now, gonna get round.
Well, it's midday. Yeah, really skirted around the last 3 hours, but confidence is sky high. And the point I was making to the lads, Jason and James, is that I've had the good fortune of being able to move into five. You know, when you book these lakes and a swim in advance, you're relying on luck when it comes to conditions, because chances are you can't often move, especially the busier waters. Here, fortunately, this swim's free, and right now with this wind blowing into the corner, I couldn't be happier. Had it been busy, the swim was taken, I'm stuck in one all week, I'd have probably packed up early, truth be known. But anyway, let's get the first rod out and yeah, have a bite to eat once all four rods are out. Starving hungry, but you know what, the adrenaline's running high and the confidence is massive.
1 o'clock, I've got 3 rods out. One over there at about 60 yards. One over there somewhere, I can't see my marker, at about 100 yards. And a third one in line with the two fir trees, which is them two there. That must be at about 180 yards. But you know what, it's a good southwesterly, it's overcast, there's wind, and it looks mad for it. Couldn't feel more confident, gotta say. And to my right, I've got Jason and James there, who are fishing in four. So yeah, pleased to be round here now, and lucky the swimmer's free. And now let's capitalise on catching some fish. Looks good. What was a swim to my left, it ain't no longer a swim. That was four, I'm in four now. But you can see the wind going into that corner. Just gonna go down there, put some bait in, and yeah, put a margin rod out.
Tell you what, if it ain't one wound, it's another. Branch has come down, hit me smack across the head. Boy, did I swear. Anyway, more importantly than that, again, that would have probably been the second time you Kent boys had gone up A&E today. What with me toe as well. Yeah, gonna get this rod out. Now, put some boilies out. You can hear the wind, you can see the wind, it's in the trees. This is perfect conditions, southwesterly. Oh, it just don't get better. Anyway, gonna cast out, fishing probably 10 yards out. Well, it's 7:30, and there ain't a bite there. Well, the LED was on. Basically, the weed is wiping out the right-hand rod, and we'll probably do the other rods before long. Perfect conditions, overcast, strong southwesterly. Looks mad for it, but that weed is just moving on the wind now. Well, it's 7:30 Monday evening, and yeah, this is hardcore really, because yeah, for no other reason really than that weed.
I've probably spent this whole video, it seems, complaining. It is what it is, and this lake's a challenge. You get a fish out of here, you're doing well. Yeah, and you know, that wind, the southwesterly's got up, I'm in a prime swim, looks mad for it. And no sooner am I thinking that, my right two rods are wiped out. So I've got two left-hand rods, sort of margin fishing, and that's the only way I can fish right now with this wind, simply because that weed's moving. But anyway, it's like you're getting in your bivvy now, going to bed. And yeah, I don't think I'll complain about 90 degrees. Castle Lake, Tom, I'm coming back, because I've had to cook for myself and my food's crap. But you know, all said and done, you know, get a fish out of here in these sort of conditions, you know, it's one hell of a fish, that's for sure. Don't matter how big it is. Don't know how well you can see it, but that's me bivvy door done up and the elements are trying to get in. Yeah, it's a wild one out there, that's for sure. Do you know what? What a plum. I'm hunting high and low for me head torch, thinking, oh, I've left it in the next swim, left it in the car. It's on me bloody head. Half eight. Tuesday morning, all four rods wiped out last night. Storm come in, it's great to see. This weed is a challenge, I think that's the polite way of putting it. The conditions look mad for it, it's just presenting the bait, that's all it is. Look, sun is out, blue sky now, southwesterly wind, looks superb. I've been in that bivvy about 12 hours, I think. Man can go stir crazy, go mad. Anyway, gonna re-tackle up, but first I'm gonna go to the town, go and get some cream buns, jam, donuts, and go to the shower. So I'm gonna go off the lake for an hour or so, come back, regroup, and get them out. Need to get off the lake for a bit now. Well, it's 10:30 now, Tuesday morning, and I've just been up for a shower, filled up with petrol, gone to the boulangerie, got me apple tart, just about to have a bite to eat, tie some different rigs, which I'll cover, and yeah, get on with it. It is what it is. These are perfect conditions. Any anglers over in the UK, anyone in France, are relishing these conditions, given the eye pressure, as I said earlier in the week, that we've had, which seemed forever. The only issue we're having here, you know, the Canadian weed here is like on Harrow 15 years ago. On Harrow, it was like a blanket of Canadian. You learnt to deal with it. It was what it was. The issue you've got here is that it moves and wipes you out. And that's the biggest problem. Other than that, you know, we've been craving this wind. It's great. The conditions overcast, southwesterly, couldn't be better. Except that wind, you know, taking out your lines. That's the issue. All of a sudden, the world's a much better place. Yeah, I think I alluded to it earlier. I can't remember now what I've said or what I ain't said. But anyway, you can probably see I had a beard and had a shave, had a shower up at the town, got some food, just had a sandwich, about to have an almond pie. Totally different tactic. And yeah, just tying up the rigs now, not rushing around, just taking my time. I've had the rods as much out of the water as I've had in the water, which has been painful, but yeah, fish will turn it all around. And if I keep sounding like I'm complaining, it's probably because I have been. Simple as that. Guys, that was a cutaway shot of what doesn't look a very unusual rig, other than the fact it's a zig rig. I was speaking with Andy Roth earlier, used to fish Harrow a lot with Andy, and he done really well 15 years ago, thanks in no small part to me as well, fishing zigs. And if you're watching this, yeah, you're, I always say you're one of the best anglers I know that people hardly heard of. So yeah, just sharing some thoughts with Andy. All four rods are going out on a zig. And basically, the idea of that is to try and present the bait. You know, when you're putting out free offerings there, out there, just like Harrow, the bait, most of it wasn't even getting to the bottom. Fish were just coming along, grazing off the top of the weed, and in many ways, and I've seen fish firsthand feeding, you know, they don't want to be rooting on the bottom when it's too difficult to get to the bait. And most of this bait that's going out there now, without a doubt, is sitting on the top of the Canadian. So long and short of it is I'm going to be fishing zig rigs, anything from 18 inches to 4 foot off the bottom, and I'm going to try it, basically. There's too many blanks going on here this year. And, you know, you come here in April, come here in November, this is a totally different ball game and much easier lake to fish. Right now, this summer, even now, that weed moving on this wind is making it impossible. Not least of all, the amount of weed on the bottom. So the idea now for the rest of the week is to fish four rigs similar to that. And a hook with a crushed down barb. And we'll cover that later on. So the idea of the crushed barb, almost barbless hook, is that if the hook does catch in the weed, it's got more chance of coming out of the weed if a fish picks it up than a barb. Just try it, you'll see what I mean. And Andy, again, thanks for your advice, buddy. And yeah, harks back to the, you know, heyday of Harrow, mate. And yeah, that's what I'm doing for the rest of the week now, because yeah, you need to be doing something a bit different here. And you know, as I said, April, November, fish it how you like. Right now, all this weed, it's a challenge, and you've got to adapt, which us Essex boys are good at doing. And it's 1 o'clock Tuesday. Just going to start baiting up now. So I've got the left-hand margin rod out, down here. Catapult distance with boilies that I put out yesterday. And the other three rods, mixture of corn, hemp, boilies, tigers, some almonds. Yeah, it's a mix I'm confident in. It's a mix that, you know, will, you know, fall at different levels in the weed, get the fish grubbing about. Just need a bite, really, to know that what you're doing is going to be right and give you a kick up the arse. But, you know, I'm fishing hard now. But, you know, you just want a fish, really. Don't care how big it is. Do you know what? Even a bream. Well, although you don't really want a bream on that rig, come to that. But, you know, when you're catching bream, at least you know your rig's presentable. But anyway, four zigs are out, or will be out. And, yeah, let's see how we get on. So going out now, putting my second left-hand rod out. And as you can see, conditions are just superb. You know, compared with flat, calm and how I saw it a few weeks back, you know, it's amazing conditions. But let's just see if my idea is going to work. It'd be nice to have a fish. So you can see I'm just like 4 foot deep here, and that is weed. This down scan, you know, this DSI imaging is fantastic. Really is good. Yeah, marker's where I left it yesterday. Just going to have a little skirt around there. And, yeah, it is what it is. You know, you could spend all day trying to find clear spots. I'm not intent on having to find a clear spot. If you find one, chances are it won't last long. So, yeah, just, you know what? Just got to get on with it. Yeah? Just get on with it. As my mum would say. Get on with it. Get on with it, son. That's what I'm going to do. Second rod's going out, no, a third rod. So, yeah, I actually put that one not where my original marker was. As I was going out, I found what looked like a better spot. About 11 foot of water, not quite so much weed about. So, yeah, I dropped that there. And I'm going to do the same here. Go out on the Echo. If anything else takes my fancy, stop. Got a spare marker here, I'll drop it in. Just play it by ear. You can see there, I'm 100 yards out from the bank. All I've got there is like a few feet of water. You can see the weed just under the surface. Last rod going out now. I need a cup of tea. I'll set the Jason and James fishing to my right. I don't normally drink when I'm fishing. I feel like I need a bottle of Southern Comfort. Honestly, I never worked so bloody hard. I'm going back to work for a rest. Anyway, let's get this out now. And, you know, just be nice to see a fish between us, that's for sure. Really give you the sort of boost you need. And know that you're doing something right. And that your presentation is at least working. That's all it is. Presentation here. That's good old Essex angling. That's called poaching.
Yeah, that's our water, really.
Yeah, love it. Hard work, isn't it? Jason and James, Colchester. Just need to get you on camera. I just said we need a fish.
Yeah?
Yeah. Need a fish. That's all we need.
Need something.
See you in a little while, boys.
Yeah.
At least if you get one, I can fish to it. You know what? Swan's just wiped out my right hand rod. I'm gonna cry. Yeah, that storm's come over. Oh, if it ain't one thing and another. So I'm gonna turn the video off and burst into tears. Well, the sun's out and the rainbow's appeared. And the lake looks lovely. I don't know if you can see that rainbow there. And all the chickens over the back there. I don't know if you can see it. Seagulls, swans, coots. But that don't matter if I get a fish. They don't make songs like that anymore. Well, it's midday Wednesday, and to cut to the chase, I've had enough, and I'm going home. I've had two rods wiped out this morning. It's too hard for me, in truth. These conditions, this time of year, this weed, too much. Yeah, so I'm packing up now. We'll be home early evening, and put this trip down to experience. Yeah, that's it in summary. Talk about it more when I get home. Got a skirt about now, get packed up, and be on my way. Well, guys,
it's the lethal weapon.
Jason and James, we didn't share capture of a fish,
no,
but we'll share a beer when we get home, hopefully celebrating you boys catching.
We'll do that.
You got me apple tart?
We have,
yeah.
We'll save it.
You try and save it,
we'll save it
until you catch one. It's a celebratory meal, right? I hope you catch, really, really do, because then this ain't a camping video. But as I'm parting now, company, Wednesday afternoon, I've had enough. And by the time I edit this video, I'll make myself look really good. Right? Don't worry about that. Yeah? So, yeah, good guys, great to meet you.
Yeah,
see you again back home, yeah?
See you soon.
Yeah, you too, James, yeah. Nice to meet you, boys, and good luck.
Yeah,
it's been a tough week for me, and hopefully you guys can turn it round.
Yeah, we'll have a go.
So this is my parting shot. Might see the lake again, might not. I'd come back when there's no weed.
I don't think there's ever no weed.
Yeah. Anyway, that's my parting shot, Wednesday afternoon, and I'm off home. Well, guys, been back a couple of days, and as you probably gathered, I needed to put that trip down to experience. That's a great lake, Etang 5, and I can't wait to go back. I'd go back in conditions that were probably, you know, are easier for me. You know, it might sound like a wuss, but that's how it was. You know, the swans, the weed moving on the wind, I just felt like I was camping with rods out as opposed to fishing. That said, James had a 20 pounder this morning, just heard from Jason, so good luck to them. They've got another 24 hours to go, but as I say, I'm going to add this footage to the beginning of my rainbow trip footage, and that'll kickstart that, which is in a couple of weeks. So yeah, thanks again to you, Mark, for making the booking so easy, and catching up with you, and I look forward to going back. Different time of year for me.